Hey friends, meet Eva. Eva is an online shopping enthusiast. She loves shopping on Zara. She's got her whole life on there basically. Her email address, her home address, even her favorite payment methods is stored on there for quick access to suffice for those impulse buys. One day, Eva gets a super tempting iMessage. It's basically an exclusive discount from Zara. And just by clicking the link, you're obviously gonna verify your account and bam, you are gonna save so much money. Or so Eva thought. Next thing she knew, her account got some really sketchy transactions. And yep, as you thought, she fell for a cyber threat. Now, how does this work? And how can you dodge the bullet if you are an online shopping enthusiast and you love shopping at Zara? Now, what are cyber attacks? Cyber attacks are those sneaky, pesky moves pulled off by hackers to usually steal something from you. This can be your data or your money or whatever purpose they have. Now, Eva specifically could have completely sidestepped this attack, right? Let's look at some of the most common cyber threats in order to overcome this. First up, ransomware. Now, think about ransomware as a digital hostage situation. A hacker, basically, locks up your data and they demand money from you to set it free. Next up, we have phishing attacks. That's basically the one that Eva fell for because it's like a phishing attack, but it happens through messaging apps. Basically, hackers play dress up and they pretend for it to be legit. You're lured into kind of clicking on all those good stuff and boom, you're basically in big trouble. The next one is cryptojacking. So imagine someone sneaks into your house, uses your electricity, and then leaves you with the bill. That's basically what cryptojacking is, but for your devices. Now, looking even further into 2023, I mean, we have gotten smarter, we have AI, and even hackers have upgraded to using AI. They now use AI to level up anything that they were already good at, and this makes them better. All right, now let's look at what Eva could have done. And she can really protect herself in style. First up, VPN. Eva should really consider being about that VPN life, because a VPN virtual private network is basically like having a secret encrypted digital tunnel for all your online adventures. Next is two-factor authentication. So if Eva only had a password, then it's most likely so much easier for people to get into her accounts if she had another factor of authentication. This just makes it a lot more challenging for anyone to get into your account. Then keeping her devices up to date. This should become a mantra. There are so many vulnerabilities in all operating systems, including iOS. So make sure you keep those operating systems up to date. Install the latest patches. It takes nothing from you. It takes a few minutes and you're good to go. Next up, a cyber savvy girl does not trust anything. They verify explicitly. Do not click random links. Eva should have gone to Zara's website and check if the sale is legit before she clicks a link. Now, friends, it's not just big businesses that get cyber attacks. It's regular people like you and I. Thousands to millions of people are being scammed every single year. Money is being stolen in small amounts or even bigger amounts, but this can make a real big difference to your pocket. So make sure that you are protecting yourself from these cyber threats. Now, for those of you who are considering a job in cybersecurity, you know that that is what I am all about. So as the cyber criminals become more, we get more jobs in cybersecurity, which can be a good thing or not, depending on how you think of it. But there are a few options that you can consider. First up, cloud security. That's a massive space right now. Everybody's moving into that space, and that's a big space to consider if you're trying to get into cybersecurity or you're trying to get into that tech girly lifestyle. Second up is a threat hunter. Then you can also look into the incident response side of things. This is where you're actually kind of hunting and try to catch criminals and then take them out of that business or network or environment. These are just some of the options that you can look into exploring if you are really trying to get into that world of cybersecurity. But if you're serious about this and you really want to start getting into your cybersecurity journey, then you should check out this video where I talk all about how to get started in cybersecurity. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this fun, simple explanation of what is cybersecurity and how it can impact you as a normal person in your daily life. If you enjoyed it, consider hitting that like button to let me know, leave a comment, and subscribe to the channel. Catch you next time. Bye.